The top stories. 25 crore rupees earmarked for development of government schools and states, says Chief Minister N. Biren. Imphal mass rally demands inclusion of Meitei Mitai Insular Tribe list STDCM to impose 36-hour general strike if government fails to act accordingly. Five shops razed to ground in Imphal inferno. And Manipur has large numbers of poor people despite schemes programs of government. Good evening and welcome to Times of Manipur. This is Suraj Khongban Tabam giving you the news. Now the news in detail. Chief Minister N. Biren has appealed to all concerned not to politicize developmental works being taken up by the state government. He was attending the inaugural function of newly constructed Ningombam High School in Nauria Pakhanglakpa Assembly constituency today. The Chief Minister also inaugurated Kwakithel Police Outpost Extension, District Veterinary Hospital Melola, Hiangthang and Kangzeibung Community Hall. The Chief Minister inaugurated the newly constructed buildings at the inaugural functions at the respective places. Held at Ningombam High School ground in Nauria Pakhanglakpa Assembly constituency today, the Chief Minister laid foundation stone for new installations of Hiangthang City Block as well. As part of the inaugural function, 1,000 CMHD cards, 2,000 Ayushman Bharat cards, gas connections under Ujwala scheme, handloom weaver cards and OLS pension cards were distributed to the beneficiaries. Addressing the gathering, the Chief Minister further said the government has earmarked 25 crore rupees for the development of government schools in the state. At least 120 new posts for nursery and pre-nursery school teachers will be commissioned soon. The government is taking up development works in both hills and valley. The government completed the construction of women market buildings at various hill districts within only 5 months. CMHD beneficiaries can get free treatment up to 2 lakh rupees. Free schoolings are being provided to underprivileged children. Clean potable water has been made available at various places for the first time since Manipur got its statehood. Loans are being given to many young entrepreneurs who are now capable of employing many other youths.
Hello India ge da hiang thang kang ge bung ge si karor ahum ba lakh hum bu mari am lo le bu si ya le ma ge le di o kar yo lo ne sa ni aduna si ge spirit de sap ma tham da ai khoi gi nauria pakhang la ba kendra se sahi manga da kyam cha sense ho gi am bio sahi ani da su kyam sense ho re di sahi manga da kamai sense ho gi am bio aduna sigi species da koi hangum chi sigi species da sap koi hangum chi yamna transparent line yamna thamoi sengna politics da usi hygiene na bi tawno gum chi politics da oi roi da bada wasak pa oi roi da bada hak ta pa hygiene bi ma tu tawno gum chi koi aduna koi gi nawna tsari bi tim chi koi with some commitment koi na hai gi wa ngak pa ngak na bu hona ba du gum tim ni aduna roi sen jera pada alaman mayam punama.
On the other hand, Works Minister T.S. Biswajit said the BJP-led government has been taking up various development projects without any biasness in both hills and valley. The state government is not at all biased when it comes to developing the state.
Now, na Ningombam da high school da sagalak leba classroom se ki inauguration tawwa abulune lune na kon yam da maru oiba rural area gi community development block ke foundation stone lingba hariba function as ki dai de lengchen biri badu ngasi gi chief guest oina lengchen biri ba myam puna magna to do khen do na ikai khuma jari ba akoi sri nongthobam biren singabu ahamung te dai kai khuna bu chari adu ga lona na koi dai de lengchen biri ba koi buji buji gam dam asi gi
demanding constitutional safeguard, the Scheduled Tribe Demand Committee Manipur STDCM today organized a mammoth public rally in Imphal city to push for the demand for inclusion of Meitei Mitai in the Scheduled Tribe list. Thousands of people from all over Manipur took part in the demonstration. Earlier in the day, the demonstrators gathered at Thau ground, Imphal, before they kicked off the protest rally, which culminated at Hatta Kang Jibung in Palace Compound. They held banners and placards during the rally. Taking part in the protest, titular King of Manipur Laysem Basanajaba emphasized on the need to provide constitutional safeguard to the indigenous people. He also stressed on the importance of inclusion of Meitei Mitei in the Scheduled Tribe list and incorporation of a special provision in the Citizenship Amendment Bill 2016 in respect of the indigenous people. Citing possible changes to be brought about by the ambitious Lucas policy of Government of India, the titular king felt that the indigenous people of Manipur could be dragged into a situation where they might face extinction owing to the upcoming Trans-Asia Highway and other activities under the policy. Hence, he said, the state government should put pressure on the government of India to translate the people's demand into action at the earliest.
Tribe lista koi maitei natraga mitei masi chanba haibasidi sidi bharat ke sangvidhan ko constitution na adum ma de piraga laira bani piraga haibadi masi mai adum pitho ga laira bani ai khoina lawda bani ala huju maksu ai na sun khanja da ngasi gi koi ge rally se maru ai na kaino ni bharat sarkar gi diko piraga laira bani ada recommendation na sangba state government dei recommendation sibu thagragadi marile na ministry na masi adum koi gi pira da po da mane ifang phanga ga lera bhai tare ko aduna swai sida koi gi pamjaba si kai hai matam da masi gi recommendation se state government na masi thu na thani yam athu bada adu state government gi su thaning da badi lera mo makoi da tharu ra ga kari taru ka de ge nakan nakan de gi ko koi tongan tongan ba koi gi si kaunu phurup yami adegi iban nei koi gi meitei mitei gi marak te su hari bang asi gi sedul tribe list san ma se phai phate pami pam de hai maya ma lei ko sigum ba gi koi gi oi ba chaen na ba khara si laibra hai bi gi singna ba de state government su kitang thinda ba oi rong ga dai khale.
Meanwhile, convener of coordinating body of Scheduled Tribe Demand Committee, Laishram Ramesh, elaborated on the need for constitutional protection to the Meitei Mitei community.
How kiba 2012 tagi hona Meitei Mitei si Scheduled Tribe ki status ta laihandana Meitei si constitution gi ngaklawuma ekoi figa da bani haiba adugunba khongjang adugunba miyam gi ba akanba yhodo madugi part amoina ekoi changsan jabani maramdi ngasi phauda manipur government na high reverb demand miyam gi oiba demand se tabi bagi hota na thaidana leiriba asibu yaning da ba amadi athu matam da india lengak ta manipur government ki oiba recommendation du thagada bani haiba adung lo wafam du da yumfam moiraga high reverb rally ase ekoi satpani.
The protest rally marched through North AOC, Kekrupat, Telipati, Soibam Laikai, Nongmeibung, Nambam Chuthek, and Konungumang before arriving at Hapta Kangjibung, where a public meeting was held. A public meeting organized by the Scheduled Tribe Demand Committee Manipur STD CM has threatened to impose a 36-hour Manipur-wide general strike beginning 6 p.m. of March 9 in case the government does not submit the necessary recommendation to the Center for Inclusion of Meitei Mitei in the Scheduled Tribe list. The meeting was held at Hapta Kangjibung after a mass protest rally held under the aegis of STD CM. The resolution to call the general strike was taken during the meet. It adopted three key resolutions: titular King of Manipur Laysem Basanajaba, STDM Working President M. Naldalin Khomba, President Professor Y. Mahindra were present during the meeting. The meeting, which was also attended by the several other prominent persons, unanimously adopted the three resolutions. The second resolution reads those leaders from different political parties and candidates who refuse to back the STDCM movement will be considered as leaders who do not think for the future, and that a campaign against such people will be launched in the coming elections. The third resolution reads if the government fails to act within 10 of March, STDCM may opt for banning the ongoing railway line construction work indefinitely from 11th of March. Laisemba Sana Chauba urged upon the state government to take steps before the code of conduct for 2019 Lok Sabha polls comes into effect. He said the constitution has a provision to grant scheduled tribe status. STDCM Working President M. Naldalen Khomba mentioned that the committee has already put up its demand to the Chief Minister and urged the government to act according to the people's resolutions adopted today. He said the government should not feel sorry for the next course of action of the committee in case it fails to implement the resolutions. Five SOPs were razed to ground in a major fire that broke out last night at Khongman Mangzil in Imphal East. The inferno happened around 10 p.m. according to a report. Fire tenders struggled to put out the ravaging fire till 3 a.m. The cause of the fire was yet to be ascertained. One carpentry shop, one tailor shop, one stationery shop, one computer DTP center, one barber shop and one automobile workshop were completely destroyed in the blaze. Meanwhile, Manipur Pollution Control Board Chairman Radha Kishore provided ₹50,000 as immediate relief to the fire victims.
Mangkhriba meyam masjid tukal phambiriba aduga yumasigi mapu loina mangba yabna te koi gamela re masigi tonganba disaster and relief department lai loina na akoi hajiksu paisa khra masigi damakta koi gamenda relief ki damakta lai gane madu pona magda koi formality mas changbuni na koi department na STC circle amadi STO amadi DC da masigi report ma athu badanga si semaga sande oijerba su makoi lakre gam department tha biro gamen tha biro madu da paket pa yabai koi soidana praja singi koi awaba khudong thibasi mateng pangana bare di tawjage haidana gamen.
Despite the repeated claim by central leaders during their visits to Manipur that the state is a poverty free region and is endowed with well educated people, it has been found that there are a lot of people living in extreme poverty in the state. One of them is one Thongam Ranjit, who is now bedridden facing a life of immobility. Here's a report.
There is a saying that human wants are unlimited. For instance, a man who has a motorcycle naturally feels like to own a car. But there are a lot of people who are struggling hard for a square meal. Family of one Thongam Ranjit, age 62 years, from Kairak Maninglekai in Kakching district, has been living a life of extreme poverty. Ranjit is now bedridden as he is incapable of moving following a major accident. His backbone was critically injured in the accident. He uses a suspension belt to support his back. Ranjit says he is a well-educated person and has several technical certificates. He was once a dutiful transporter driving different types of vehicles, and during that time, he used to earn a lot of money. Besides this, he would grow vegetables in the backyard and also rear ducks and chickens. And apparently saddened, Ranjit asks himself who will do all these jobs now. Ranjit has three sons. With the help of the elder one, Thongam Bobo, along with his wife, Ranjit underwent medical treatment at Regional Institute of Medical Sciences, Imphal, for some time. Due to lack of money, Ranjit had to leave the hospital and return home. Still, the family owes a lot of people as a huge amount of money was spent in his treatment. In the hope to pay back the debt and start a new treatment for his father, Bobo has left home to earn money. Adding woe to the family, his second son, Thongam Birbal, recently had a costly surgery to remove stones from his kidney. Birbal's suffering did not end here. Following the surgery, Birbal was diagnosed with cancer. He's currently undergoing medical treatment at Chamber of Commerce, Imphal. Now, Thongam Ongbi Inaubi, wife of Ranjit, has been forced into a life of daily wage earner. She has to take up all kinds of odd jobs to sustain livelihood. The youngest son, Thongam Kambaton, is now only 10. Kambaton has stopped going to school due to poverty. He was supposed to be in class 5. Now, the land owned by Ranjit exists only in name, since the whole property is expected to be taken away by some people who have lent money to him. His wife sometimes has to keep herself fighting to ward off money collectors from several microfinance institutes. She has a lot of loan money to be repaid to them. Inaubi took the money for buying medicines for her husband. To help cope with the severe condition of the family, help has been sought from all walks of life, including leaders of the government, so that sufferings of the family can be eased at some extent.
Well, it's time now for a short break.
Lamzingba Jewelry na adom gidamak kwaidagi asengba sana kwaidagi ahongba sana asamalda fanganzari. Ekoi gi service sing di inat kyoiba design sing ready made ta fanganzari. Singnaningai oidraba asengba sana khaktamak pizari. Manung matam sana order delivery sing pizari. Sana asamal kwaidagi name na luxury. Normizing numitsu adom gi service ta luxury. Nasimak Lengsin Birau, Lamzingba Jewelry Private Limited, DM College Road, opposite Memsi Mall, Thangmaiban, Imphal West. Email lamzingbajewelry@gmail.com. Website www.lamzingbagoldbank.com. Contact us at 764-29-34425 and 940-299-2391. Lamzingba Jewelry. Good quality is our priority.
Welcome back after the break. A one-day seminar cum workshop on integrating skill development in higher education was held at MIMS Auditorium today. The program was organized by Dhanamanjuri Community College, DM University, Imphal, under the funding of University Grants Commission, UGC Notice Office, NERO Guwahati.
Criteria are to be discussed in different academic forums, especially among the students, so that they can learn how the newer policies can be harnessed, how are the government developmental programs, they can be utilized for the welfare of the students, their improving their employability and economic development of the region. So I personally feel that such kind of the activities, these are organized regularly and if the newer developments are discussed regularly from time to time, ultimately this will benefit our students to upgrade their knowledge. They will it will sensitize our faculty members to involve into the newer initiatives, and ultimately it will improve the economic development of the region.
UGC Nero Guwahati Education Officer Dr. Nikhil Kumar said during the program that students need to work on bringing about a big change in the state economy by understanding various developmental programs being taken up by the government. Over 300 students from different colleges took part in the program. DDU Center Director and Kaushal Nodal Officer Dr. Muhammad Rahizuddin Sheikh said that though Manipur has a number of well-educated people, there are a lot of unemployed people. He said the main objective of the program was to encourage students to earn money and create avenues to provide jobs in others. He said DM Community College has produced many successful students since its inception in 2014.
Koi lari lai so hairaba thabak thiriba narol sing thabak suning basing ase government ki sector da thabak lak amadagi hena pibang ngamdirgadi kada kada da atai thabak tophom leibage haibase masi alternative option noina atoppa option noina thirakpa matam da akoi bharat sarkar na so masi ki issues ki khangatana akoi skill based vocational education system ama hodui maru oina 2013 14 adwai dagi horaga maduda ahan bada community college sing linkhatli diploma bhaugi skill based vocational programs ta ade ko skill lom da khare hena emphasis pi bhai tare moin madu hel orga industry sing da natraga private sector sing da natraga na masan business sector am linkha charga entrepreneur ne thabak to yana ba government na khong sadana ba thabak phangda ba hai badu leitana ba gi damak ta madu gi mohuta thabak pi ba rom da ade employee oi bi mohuta employer oi hen ba yuani
Manipur Education Minister T.H. Radhesyam has said that the state government is planning to formulate a welfare policy for ex-servicemen. He was participating in a program of Sainik Sammelan at BJP Manipur Pradesh temporary office located at Kanchipur in Imphal West today. Organized by Manipur BJP unit, the event was participated by party president and MP KSA's Bhavananda and retired General Ellen Singh and presidium members. The Manipur BJP presented simple gift to the ex-servicemen on the occasion. Minister Radhesyam asserted that discipline is the most important part of one's life. He said, "We need to do something in our life for the betterment of the country." Radhesyam assured that he would consult the chief minister so that the government can take up steps for the welfare of ex-servicemen. He announced that he will donate rupees 1 lakh annually from the local area development fund for taking up welfare program for ex servicemen.
Successful oyo miyam oyge da apaba miyam oyge tare discipline. Discipline nai bese army khakta da armed forces khakta le lai gane. Discipline lai ba potu yawra kan da khoi apaba samaj oyge do do discipline yawo mi sing sina moina thoraktna active oina oiraktra kan involved doctor kan le koi samaj discipline kai sakani mayam obirudne aduna masi semgat pa koi phatana lai bai se dakar tai
Several ex-servicemen who were working with armed forces, navy and air force took part in the program. Speaking at the event, MP KSA's Bhavananda said, "Sainik Sammelan has given a new strength to us." He stated that BJP believes in nationalism. Bhavananda assured that he will do his best to facilitate all requirements for setting up of a Sainik board.
We can never be united when we are diversified. So we have to always think that we are one. Until unless we all believe that we are one, India is my country, Bharat is my country, we can never unite.
Let's take a short break once again.
Mitei kenu. This pond is not an ordinary one. It is a place of history that still remains to tell us the story of an unbreakable relationship between Assam and Manipur. Mangda Lairiba Pukhri Asina Assam Amasung Manipur Gi Manak Takari Mari Lenarami Sigi Matanga Ahanbo Oina Times of Manipur Na Miyamda Paudamgani Moglo Hariba Wahayasi Karino Midian Taminesi Times of Manipur.
Lamjingba group na Manipur da lairiba assembly constituency humphudagi mathau da pukning changba public relationship executive post ki miyoi amamam lagjagadori mahegi thag yamdrabada graduation oigedabani akup marol gidamak contact tobiro @131944063 amukasu @131944063 aikhoi address Lamjingba group Rims Road Imphal phone number @131944063.
Welcome back. A drug peddler was arrested along with 9,869 capsules of spasmoproxibon SP capsules by a team of commando personnel of Bishnupur police yesterday afternoon around 12:30. Mohammed Amir Khan is a 26-year son of Mohammed Yakub Ali of Quetta was arrested along the contraband item during routine frisking and checking conducted by the commando team led by officer in charge PH Sunil Singh under the supervision of additional superintendent of police operation Bishnupur police at Quetta ward number 7. One Activa scooter and one mobile phone were also recovered from his possession. A police statement said today he was later handed over to Moirang police station for further necessary action, the statement said. One person died while some sustained injuries in a road mishap wherein a Maruti car and an Activa collided at Nambol Savanlikai under Nambol police station around 9 last night. The deceased is yet to be identified. Nambol police has registered a case over the incident. A person reportedly drowned in a river flowing through Chabung company under Mayang Imphal police station around noon today. The body has not been recovered. The person has been identified as one Sapam Satyajit alias Koro Hanba aged 15, son of Ango from Chabung company Makhalikai. The locals were trying to recover the body. Thoubal District Police Commando nabbed one cadre belonging to KCP War Group from his residence around 7:30 this morning. The cadre has been identified as Maisnam Ratan Singh, 24, son of Sanathoy from Tentha Khunau Awanglaikai. He joined the group through a person named Amarjit from Khangabog in November last. Through him, it has come to know that he was involved in extortion cases relating to several private schools at Khangabog, police said. A combined team of Imphal West District Police Commando and Narcotics and Affairs of Borders NAB conducted a search operation in some suspicious rooms of Hotel Classic Grand at Ching Mai Rong last midnight, which continued till early morning today. Sources informed that the operation was conducted after a tip-off that a team of gold smugglers were staying at their hotel. However, there were no reports of arrest. The 11th Foundation Day of Cine Editors Guild Manipur was held at Sankar Talkies Lumphel Path today. Chairman of Film for Manipur S. Mangol Jao Singh, President of Cine Editors Guild Manipur K. Bimal Sharma, Senior Filmmaker L. Surjakanta Sharma, Editor of Local Newspaper Naharol Githaudang K. H. Loya Lakpa, Vice President of Cine Actors Guild and J. Vidya and Secretary of Amphim Pap Premjit Nauribam were the main guest at the function. Rich tributes were paid to the late eminent filmmaker M.A. Singh during the program. Nongthombam Premananda, Best Editor Awardee of 11th Manipur State Film Award and Best Editor Awardee of 8SS Manifa 2019, Sarat Kumar Aribam were also felicitated at the event. As part of the program, sponsors of Cine Editors Football Club were also facilitated.
Manipur se ahamada mi je celluloid film mo intorok panina editor se yamna pakna lene namde aduna editor gilam se mada mi se yamna leitam nina yam kana se mangam gide akoi gi digital era chang padagi digital gi kana chang padagi di akoi editor masing yam kale mi se masing yam kale padagi gi koi somna kana so film forum koi mani film so chokolak pa adi film yam yam kolak pa nam kolak pa or padagi asi di film forum na so akoi gi gilam se mna khotna bana maina takbirak pa 2008 February 7 jida mayam punjil laga akoi gi film forum gi office hai tare lampenda lebiwa stage da kasu jang kandana akoi gi editor khara akoi yamung lalmani hoy akoi ka moi khara pul laga maina toraga gil se sembira man hai tare.
Now let's have the top stories of today's newspaper headlines.
The People's Chronicle. Chief Minister banks on central aid to realize water dream. House sells plan to take CAB vote. Biren Ministry reshuffle likely in few days. Three arrested with drugs at Palay. Northeast India throws up Asia's oldest bamboo fossils. The Imphal Free Press. Opposition MLAs withdraw private members. Resolution under Rules of Proceeding 109. Committee probing allegations against Vishi Pandey finalizes inquiry report. Inquiry report of students' dead at juvenile home yet to be submitted. House passes 7 demands for grants amounting to rupees 484.75,89,000. The Morning Bail. IPR minister proposes to raise journalists' pension to rupees 10,000. House passes 7 demands for grants amounting to rupees 4,847.58 crore. All tribal students union Manipur peeved at LH injustice to tribal MPS officers. One killed, 3 injured in road accident. District election officer Churachandpur reviews poll preparedness. Manipur Mail. Media park to be built at Langjing Achoba, says Vishwajit. Community policing center at Churachandpur.
Before we wind up, let's have a quick look at the top stories once again. ₹25 crore earmarked for development of government schools in state, says Chief Minister N. Biren. Imphal mass rally demands inclusion of Meitei Mitei Institute tribe list. STDCM to impose 36-hour general strike if government fails to act accordingly. Five shops razed to ground in Imphal Inferno. And Manipur has large number of poorest people despite schemes programs of government. Well, that's all for now. Keep watching Times of Manipur. Thank you.